Hi, welcome back. In this session, I introduce about MUnit. Basically, we use MUnit to do the unit testing. First, let's understand what is unit testing. Testing are validating a smallest unit of code to verify as it works as expected or not is called as unit testing. Even though we develop the business process as a big flow, but still that can be divided into units of pieces and that can be tested. That is called as unit testing. And again, collaboration of all these unit tests together, those results will outcome single system and it provides how it behaves. Each developer in their real time should do unit testing. The unit testing is one of the responsibility of each developer. Whatever the code a developer develops, that can be unit tested in two ways. So far we know how we can do manual testing, but each and every technology is supporting us to do the test-driven development by writing any automation scripts using some existing frameworks like MUnit. MuleSoft has provided MUnit to do test-driven development to automate test cases and avoid manual testing. And Java provided JUnit. In similar way, MuleSoft has provided MUnit. Basically, why we need unit testing? What happens if we don't test each unit of complete program? Assume a car manufacturer company is manufacturing a car. And one by one, they are installing together to make the car. Assume they have not tested the car unit by unit. And after manufacturing completely and they started to drive it and test all the parts of the car, there are chances of occurring more bugs since it has not unit tested and all the units together tested at a time. Like there is a chance of failing brakes, there is a chance of gear doesn't work as expected, there is a chance of clutch doesn't work as expected. So that produces the fixing of bugs and also the ratio of work will be increased. To avoid that, whenever they fit a brake, if they test immediately, that means the brake unit testing has done successfully. In similar way, each part can be tested separately at end. By finishing the car, they can feel that and also they can feel confident all peripherals being tested individually so that they can have confidence to drive the car, hoping the car will work as expected. Even though there are small bugs happen, still that can be fixed easily. That is the main use of unit testing. In real time, whenever we develop any integrations, either REST APIs or any event-based or schedule-based, any other flows, those flows should be tested individually rather than group. Assume we are making some integrations with some backend systems. Assume we are developing a REST service and at first we want to integrate with the database. Then we want to integrate with by consuming one of the SOAP service. As a developer, how we do develop and test this? If I am a developer, first what I will do? I do development of REST service. First, I incorporate database call. Once it's done, then I will test until that, whether it is working as expected or not. Then if it is working fine, then next I incorporate SOAP service consuming call. Rather than that, I don't do database call, then immediately consuming a SOAP service, then I don't test altogether. Rather than that, even while developing also, even though we do manual testing, whatever we develop, better to test unit by unit. MuleSoft has provided MUnit framework to do MUnit test cases development, to do the unit testing. Let's understand the benefits of unit testing. We can able to isolate the section of code, and we can able to validate whether it is working as expected or not. That means even though we have big flow, but still we can isolate some part of the flow, we can develop a MUnit test case, and we can validate how it is working as expected. Assume we have done a lot of enrichments in one transform message logic, and we wanted to test each and every enrichment. But if we test all together, we need to test each and every component every time. Suppose I am making the database call, then fetching the data, then doing the enrichments, then calling one of the SOAP service. But I want to test only these enrichments. Is that possible? Yes. Rather than testing end-to-end flow manually, we could able to develop a unit test case to separately test the all enrichments have done in the transform message. So we can isolate a section of the code, and we can develop a MUnit test case, and we can validate it. And the unit testing, the development of MUnit test cases, always helps us identifying the bugs in each stage of SDLC or in each section individually, immediately itself, before it is going to the testing. And also it saves the cost, and also the number of bugs can be resolved at the earliest. Helps the developers to improve the design by allowing refactoring of the code. If we are developing a Mule flow without considering MUnit, sometimes we could able to do development by losing some chances of better coding. Whereas if we consider MUnit in our mind, then that helps us improving the flow code development. We will see that. And also, it simplifies debugging the process by each unit. With the proper unit testing practice, components that are going to be integrated, we can easily get the quality product. Just now I said the car manufacturing. If each part of the car as unit tested by unit, then we can definitely assure a quality product in the end. In similar way, whatever the integrations we've developed, if those unit tested by part, at end, we should definitely feel confident and we assure that we have delivered a quality product. Coming to the MUnit. MUnit is a Mule application testing framework that allows us to easily build automated tests to test our integrations and APIs. Since MuleSoft is based on connectors approach, for MUnit also, MuleSoft has provided the connectors so that we can easily able to build the MUnit test cases. The MuleSoft has provided a framework with a full suite of integration and unit test capabilities, and fully integrated with Maven for continuous deployment environment. The advantage of developing MUnit test cases is whenever we do CI/CD and deploying applications to the servers, those unit test cases can be validated before doing the deployment. That means the Maven plugin helps us to do validation of unit test cases before the deployment. If the test cases coverage has not at least reached 80%, then the deployments automatically will be failed. Or any one of the test cases has failed, then the deployment will be failed. So this way, the unit test cases can be validated. Why we should do integrate with CI/CD? Because today you developed the flows and you have also developed unit test cases. Later that some enrichments came on the same flow and any enrichments has done and unit test cases has not covered or has not enriched. During the time, if we are deploying the application, then there is a chance of several unit test cases will be failed, so that the deployment will be failed. This is required because whatever we do enrichments later, the impact should be tested and the unit test cases should be enriched accordingly. Correct? What we can do with MUnit? We can create test cases by writing MuL code. We would able to mark the processors. What is processor? Already we know we have event source and event processor. The event processors can be marked. We will see in upcoming sessions. We can able to spy any processor. We can verify processor calls. We can enable or ignore particular tests if required. And also we can able to tag the test, check visual coverage in the studio, how many test cases has succeeded, how many test cases has failed, and what is the percentage of the unit test cases has succeeded. And also we could able to generate those coverage reports. We will see these in coming sessions. So to do MUnit test cases development, MuleSoft has supplied two modules. One is MUnit and one is MUnit tools. If we wish to work with MUnit test cases, we should aware of all the connectors of MUnit module and MUnit tools. Each module has its own dependency, and those dependencies look like this for MUnit and MUnit tools. Coming to the MUnit modules, we have two types of connectors. One is related to operations and one is related to scopes and routers. The operations contains set event, set null payload, and scopes and routers contains before suit, after suit, before test, after test, and test. We will see these connectors one by one. And coming to MUnit tools contains same kind of module. Those are operations and scopes and routers. Coming to the operations, we have asset equals, asset that, asset expression, mark when, verify call, run custom, fail, clear stored data, DQ, queue, remove, retrieve, sleep, store, store OAuth token. And coming to the scopes and routers, we have spy. We will see these connectors one by one. Let me show you these connectors in the studio. Then we will start with an example. Here, I have developed a simple REST service that is MuL Allow API. In this flow, we will get first name and last name as query parameters. And I am just concatenating as a full name by saying welcome to MuL. Even we can see the logic here. Here, I just written logic as welcome to MuL and attributes dot query params dot first name, and I am keeping a space between first name and last name, and attributes dot query params dot last name. So if I send first name, last name as query parameters, it first prints the start log, then prepares the response as welcome to MuL first name, last name. Suppose I am sending first name as Chinna, then last name as Reddy. It will respond me back as welcome to MuL Chinna Reddy. And here I am keeping a end log saying that completed allow MuL flow. So let's develop a MUnit test case for this. just right click on the flow, go to M unit, click on create blank test for this flow. Immediately under source test M unit, a flow will be generated as test case. Let's give some meaningful name as hello test. Mule hello API success test case. And if you see, as I mentioned, MuleSoft has given two modules for MUnit. One is MUnit and one is MUnit tools. Coming to the MUnit, we have these many connectors. Those are set event, set null payload, after suit, after test, before suit, before test, test. And MUnit tools contains these as discussed. And we use these connectors to develop MUnit test cases. Let's do a manual test of this application and see the results. Then we will come to the test suite and we will do a unit test case development. I am already running this application. Let's make a request. And here I made the URL http localhost 8081 and sub URI is hello. And I am sending first name, last name. Let's make the request. Now we can see the response as welcome to Mule Chinnareddy. And if you notice here, while doing manual testing or even we are developing MUnit test cases, we should remember some terminology. What was that? Here, what I was doing for the running application, when I make the request, first what was happening? Execution was happening. Then the connector, the under transform message, whatever the logic I have written and that has responded. That means the behavior is happening. The terminology here I am stating, the first is execution and the next is behavior. And how we would know the expected results has came here? Because in manual testing, we would able to assert that the response is coming as expected. So here I used three words. One is first, I am making the execution. And next, the behavior is happening or not in the connector or in the flow. Yes, happening. And I would able to assert whatever the response is coming. If you go to any technology, whenever we develop test cases, and we wanted to develop automated test cases, then everywhere this terminology helps us. And if you see here, whatever has generated here is test connector. And if you see in the MUnit, if I drag and drop this test connector, it has execution section, nothing but this section is responsible to provide the execution. Someone should able to trigger out something, then only we would able to get the results. That means this section is of execution. And coming to the validation, assert that I am saying, validating, we are validating the response. There are three things: behavior, execution, validation. Coming to the execution scope is responsible to trigger the flow, whatever we want to test. Coming to the behavior, here we add marks and spice. For now, don't worry about it. We are going to see in upcoming sessions. And coming to the validation, here we assert whether the expected result has came or not. And we do development in these three sections to finish a test case. Let's do one. Let me delete it. And here, if you see by default, a flow reference is generated. And here it was calling Mule Hello API flow. You can think that Mule Hello API has event source and it has event processor. Test case always calls event processor. It won't care about the event source so that we can use flow reference to call this event processor. That is the reason we have event processor here. But as we know, this processor is expecting two query parameters, correct? Then how we can automate the way of passing two query parameters? We know that, right? Basically, whenever a request comes here, what carries the input? Event, a mule event, correct? What mule event contains? It contains payload, attributes, error, correct? Now, we have a connector called set event to set the input required by the processor. And here you see payload, attributes, error, variables. So whatever the data we want to process to this, we can supply through the set event. That is the significance of set event. We would able to set this event. We can keep either in the execution part or we can keep in the behavior part. But I would suggest you to keep in the execution so that it will have uniformity. We will use this behavior scope to mark and to spy. And coming to this set payload or set event, anything, try to keep in the execution section. Some developers keep in behavior section also. Don't worry about that. Now, do I need to send any payload? Not required. The processor, the event processor, nothing but the section right side to these dots, this section, is expecting two query parameters. Now let's supply query parameters. And coming to the attributes, how this value should be supplied? Always we should supply in the expression, and that should look like this expression. And in this we would able to pass any headers or query parameters or URI parameters. How I can send? So query params, this is same like attributes dot query params we write, right? So we need to keep the that query params colon, this would look like a JSON payload. And again we need to put open brace and close brace because I want to supply multiple parameters. First name, as Chinna. So whatever we have tested manually, now we are making it as automated. Second name as Reddy. Now you can get a doubt, if this is expecting URI params, then how can I send URI params? Comma URI params in similar way, correct? But let's keep it to query params for now. We will see in coming sessions about other attributes. Just keep it. Now it was showing some error. Let me figure it out. Yes, here I need to close one more close this. Save it. So we would able to set the query params to the event so that it will be carried to this event processor through the flow reference call. Now once it comes here, this execution will be done. Once the execution will be done, in manual testing we would able to assert manually, oh, expected response is coming or not. Yes, coming. But how we do the same in automation? We can do using, or we can do in three ways. If you go to MUnit tools, we have assert equals, we have assert expression, we have assert that. The assert equals always do only equals assertion. Coming to the assert expression, we would able to write data view script inside this to assert the result. And coming to the assert that has inbuilt matcher assertions, those functions will help us to, let's go with assert equals first. And here I am going to validate payload dot message. And what I was expecting, message as welcome to Mule Chinna Reddy. If the response is coming like this, that means the expected results are came. If not, what we should say? Response payload is not correct. Save. For safe side, let me add a logger here to print the payload to make sure the flow has called, and also we would able to get the payload. Before running test case, we should stop the existing application if it is running. Now go to test case, right click here, just click on run mUnit. So the application has started, and next it is going to run the test case that we added here, and we can see something mUnit here. Now we can see it has errored out, but I want to show you here it was saying that running suit, this particular suit for test cases, and let's see the error. Cannot coerce null. As since we are sending the query param, it has not went as query param. Let's see why it has error. Yes, here I given as first name, last name, but by mistake here I given as second name. Sorry for that. Let's give proper key as last name. Since it went as null, the null cannot be coerced to the string. That is the reason our flow has errored out. And here, what is the fix I should do? Here, I should default it to some empty string. Save. Now let's go back here, run the suit again. Now we can see the test suit started the execution, and here in the logger we have printed the result, response of the API or event processor that we are unit testing, and it has printed like this. Now we can see the test cases execution has done, and we can see here the green mark. That means the test case has succeeded. And also we can see the coverage. The coverage is each component, each connector of the flow has executed. So this way we do unit testing. And in coming session, I will show you how we can work with assert expressions, assert that, and also what, how many matchers or expressions these contains. That's all about this session. See you in next session. Thank you and happy learning.